But oh, look! Woo-hoo. I can use some of that 43 kilos of drag that we got. That's a oh, that's a proper fish, eh, guys?
Yeah.
Coming out deep to harvest some food, but also to try out this new bad boy, the Shimano Beastmaster 12K. It is the big boy of the Shimano stable as far as the electric reels go. We've got Johnny here from Shimano, who's had, I've just been talking about the reel, the man himself that designed this rod. And it's a rod that is apparently capable of handling the 48 kilograms, yes, 48 kilograms of drag that this reel has. Was that right, 48 kilos?
43.
48 sounds way better.
The rods tested the 48?
The rods tested, I knew there was a 48 in there somewhere. So I got my schooling up on all the specs on the way out. You're gonna come to know throughout the course of the day, if you don't already, I'm not a real specs techo guy. I'm a hands-on practical guy. So you're gonna get a very literal upfront appraisal of how this gear works. And hopefully you'll see it winching in some big old fish. If this goes well, as in we catch our bluenose and bass on the Beastmaster 12K, we're going to be using this very same reel today to try and catch a swordfish. I know our brothers in North America do that, and I've been calling them pussies for years, but I'm not taking that back, by the way. But anyway, we're going to go and see if we can break Johnny's rod on a swordfish. 48 kilos of drag, he says, eh?
48 kilos.
Yeah.
That's where it's tested to break it anyway.
Well, well, let's
now
see.
That the bait's bounced out.
We're going to find out. But and amidst all of this, what I've just realised is we've just hooked our first fish midway through my intro on this reel. And the first thing I notice is how easily this thing's working. A lot quieter than the 9000. And that's boosting the line in. And here it comes popping up here. That is actually a reasonable sized bluenose. And I thought it was a really small gemfish. Oi, 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 get out of it, Yahuwah. That's our dinner. So, oi, oi, get out of it. And that was all just a little bit too easy. Right now is Johnny's time to shine. Tech guru and the man behind the rod development. And the rod was made for this new Beastmaster 12,000, right?
Yep,
specifically.
Definitely. Yeah, so we went to our factory, we custom designed this rod to be able to withstand the, not only the 43 kgs of drag the reel can put out,
yeah,
but it's actually tested up to 48 kgs.
Wow.
That's at 45 degrees, and that's like an actual breakage test.
Gotcha.
We tried to go higher than that, and the factory actually broke their testing machine when we tried to do that, so.
Wow.
Yeah, she's got some boogie. The rod's got T45 construction in the blank. So that's basically carbon tape wrapped at 45 degrees. How that works is you can use less carbon to make a lighter rod, maintain strength, and it also reduces twist.
Wow, Roger.
So that's pretty cool. EFCO UV4 butt, so we've got a bit of extra length, so you can have nice clearance between the reel and the side of your boat. Yeah, 6 foot long as well, so again, we've got a bit of clearance to keep the line away from the side of the boat, make it easy to see from the helm station. The reel, the Beastmaster, this was actually designed in the US for the Florida swordfish market,
gotcha,
originally. But we've got the biggest swords in the world down here in New Zealand, so.
Yeah, we do.
So this reel, as I said before, it's got 43 kgs drag.
Yeah.
The practical actual winding power is 38 kilos, so that basically means that that is based pretty much what it can maintain
while it's
strength
winching
and wind.
Wow.
Against 38 kilos.
That's still amazing.
It's also got a maximum speed of 170 meters a minute.
Yeah.
I highly doubt it's going to do that when there's a sword attached though.
No.
Funnily enough. And it's also got what's called a thermo adjust drag. So basically the drag system is designed to maintain its pressure when it gets hot without jamming up.
Oh wow. Tech guys. I like it. Well, it sounds like it's the business. So far we've caught a few bluenose on it, hardly a test for it, but when we get that swordfish on, we're going to see if this lives up to everything it says on the packet. We've seen loads of footage coming out of Florida of swordfish, and I think they talk about a 200 pounder being a big one. So far this season, I think I've only caught three under 200 pound. The rest have been, you know, up to 650 pounds.
Eat it, boys.
Long-time viewers of my stuff will know that I catch some big swordfish and will have seen the strain that goes on like a Tiagra Ultra. Will it handle a swordfish while it's sitting in the rod holder like that?
But that's what we're here to find out, right?
Gotcha. Okay. Finished the description and we have hooked the fish. And it's doing its best to pull hard, but oh, look! Woohoo! I can use some of that 43 kilos of drag that we got. That's a, oh, that's a proper fish, eh, guys?
Yeah.
Are we pretty much on that same mark?
Nah, we got moving a little bit, eh?
Okay, as soon as that current picked up, just like I said, eh? Need that current, the old saying, no run, no fun. Oh, shit, yes. And so the mode that we're in is Raku Raku mode, and it's designed, rather than to keep a constant speed, to keep a constant pressure on the fish, which is important in terms of holding the hook in, but also not ripping it out. So if the fish was to swim up, it's not gonna over rev and overcompensate, and then when it changes direction, impact load. Yay! Obviously not hard work. All the work's been done here. Now, social media warriors can get a little bit wound up calling it cheating. And what I say to that is, yeah, true. No, it is. It is cheating, and if you're in terms of sport. But we're out here to harvest. So the quicker and more efficiently we can catch our fish, the more we can go prospecting new spots. Anyone that comes out for the first time and I say, do you want to catch a big bass? I make them do it manually. And I say, that way you can really own it. But here, no doubt about it, it is cheating, but we're harvesting, and hey, look, it's working. And right now, it is 14 meters away. Here it comes. It's gonna float up out there, boysies. And there we go. That was our bass, and that was no trouble at all. So not only is that amazing eating, that is just cool to catch. They're a cool fish. And look at that, he's gone for the old kahawai head. Ooh, this is going to be heavy, guys. How are we going to get on here? Far out. Gosh. Yep, that's proper good one. Okay, I want to be careful here. And there it is. Big old bass winched in by the big boy in the Shimano stable. The Beastmaster 12K. Because our reel's done all the work, this is the hardest part of the operation for me. Yeah. Here we go, boys. How's that light? Is that good? Fantastic. That Beastmaster in there. Okay, I'll get you to hold it open.
So that's my review on the new Beastmaster 12,000.
Yep.
We've actually got an all new full episode from this day that's got loads more action from the deep.
Oh, yeah, yeah. The rod.
As well as how to care for, prepare, and even smoke all of these fish that we catch. As well as all the tips and techniques on how to find and catch fish in deep water, including the mighty swordfish.
Oh, that was gone. Oh, we got something on.
Look at the sword on there.
Forward.
Yep, tags in them, boys. So just subscribe to our Ultimate Fishing channel on YouTube or download our free Ultimate Fishing app to see this and hundreds more fishing action videos, as well as all the how-to vids. You can follow me, Matt Watson, on Instagram and Facebook, and you're also gonna wanna follow Ultimate Fishing on all the social media channels.